Mainers will have to wait another year at least to vote on whether to force a takeover of our two biggest electric utilities.
And they were not able today to override the governor's veto of the Pine Tree Power Bill. But that debate is not over. And possibly this year's spending decisions are not finished either. Here's News Center Maine's Don Carrigan from Augusta.
The issue seems as charged as the systems it deals with. Lawmakers voted June 30th in favor of the Pine Tree Power Bill to form a consumer-owned utility to force a takeover of CMP and Versant.
I'm today issuing a veto letter concerning LD 1708.
Governor Mills, calling it one of the most consequential bills ever to hit the legislature, vetoed it. In the House, there are clearly still strong feelings on the issue from supporters, including the sponsor, Representative Seth Berry.
75% of Mainers support being able to create a consumer-owned utility, nonprofit utility to replace CMP and Versant, these foreign-owned, for-profit monopolies.
But also plenty of opposition, including Auburn Representative Bruce Bickford.
You know, we could call it Chinese electric or Venezuela electric or Russian electric. We are not that type of country. We're not a socialist country. We don't take over businesses that we don't like.
But when the vote came in the House, they weren't even close to the two-thirds majority needed to override the veto, meaning Pine Tree Power is shut off for now. But the group called Our Power, which supports the plan, says it will launch a petition drive right away to get the issue to voters next year. Their statement reading, while politicians in Augusta have failed to let Maine ratepayers weigh in on this important question this year, we will make sure that voters' voices are heard in 2022. Money is also key to what may be the last big decision by these lawmakers. Democrats in the Senate and House voting in favor of a nearly $1 billion spending plan for using federal COVID relief money. Republicans are opposing the bill in part because Democrats added an item last week using $20 million for housing projects requiring a project labor agreement that unions like. Governor Mills objected to the bill, calling on legislators to keep working on it and to reach a bipartisan agreement so the money for all those projects could be available this summer. So far, no changes have happened. Now there's lots of speculation here at the State House. The governor might issue a rare line item veto. If that happens, lawmakers would likely be called back here again for more votes. In Augusta, Don Carrigan, News Center Maine.
The leader of the group, Maine Affordable Energy, which is opposing Pine Tree Power, put out a statement saying borrowing $13 billion from Wall Street banks to seize CMP and Versant Power would saddle Maine ratepayers with a debt that would take decades to pay off through our electric bills.